Hello everyone, welcome to Vix Tarot Guidance. Welcome if you're new and welcome if you're returning to this channel. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already. And if any of you are here interested in booking personal tarot readings with me, all the information about that can be found in the description box and also in the pinned comment below this video. So today we are going to be looking at a very standard reading that we have on this channel every now and then. And this is going to be the video about your person's thoughts and feelings about you and about your connection. So we're going to be doing like a quick little energetic check-in for your person, for their thoughts, feelings about you and about this connection. We have three groups to choose from over here. If you are already vibing with a specific group, if you're already sort of really drawn to a specific group, you can skip the introduction and just go right ahead and scroll down below to your group's timestamps, which are in the description box and also in the pinned comment below this video. So if you feel like you need a bit more of an introduction, with group number one here, we have this beautiful opalite crystal, very beautiful angelic source frequencies here with this one. Then we have group number two with unikite crystal. This one resonates with the root chakra, the heart, and the third eye. It's very grounding, but also very opening and intuitive. It's also known as the Stone of Rebirth. And for group number three, we have the beautiful heart opening and gentle rose quartz frequency today. So these are the three groups to choose from. You can pause this video if you feel like you need a bit more time picking, choosing, feeling into your particular crystal. You can be guided to more than one crystal. That's perfectly fine also. That just means that you have messages in more than one group. And also, you know, you can pick groups for multiple people. You can pick a specific crystal and sort of assign it to one specific person or one specific connection. And if you're asking about, you know, multiple connections, you can sort of assign multiple groups to multiple special people in your life. This is also a timeless reading, as said. And every time that you are finding this video is a perfect time to be aligning with the messages found here. So you can feel free to pause the video. As said, the timestamps for each individual group are in the description box below this video. So feel free to scroll down below and click on your chosen groups, and I'll see everyone in your chosen pile. Hello, group number one. If you pick this gorgeous opalite angel frequency today, this is going to be your video for what are your person's current thoughts and feelings about you and about your connection. So let's see what wants to come through today for you guys. We are going to be quickly drawing a couple of these oracle cards just to see what wants to come through here today. So group number one, what's happening here, please, Spirit? What are their person's current thoughts and feelings about this connection? Where is this person at? We have transformation and we have live in the moment showing up for you. So transformation here is letting me know that they are in the midst of one state towards the other. So it almost feels like they are at this time cocooned, suspended even in this whirlwind and sort of hurricane of transformation. I am feeling your person is being quite still in the midst of this transformation. So it almost feels like they are in the eye of the storm. They feel like they are quite chill, they feel very at peace, but at the same time, everything around them is sort of shifting, changing, transforming, and becoming new, becoming different. So it is taking them a little while to become accustomed to everything, especially regarding this connection. Also, we have let love transform you forever. I am feeling this connection has had a major impact on your person and on their personal life at the moment. Also, you know, their business life, their career, everything relating their life. It has been like a major upheaval energy, and they are so sort of being pushed to and fro a little bit because of it, but also it feels like they are very much at peace at the moment regarding everything. The energy that I was feeling into before regarding them being a little bit sort of tossed to and fro is regarding their past experiences more. Right now I am feeling them very sort of collected in the midst of everything that is changing. They're sort of living there in the here and now. And so beautiful that we have here live in the moment card showing up for your person as well, because yeah, they are currently in this energy. We have what you are looking for is with you. So they are very much at peace with where they are at the moment. They feel very calm, very collected, even though there is so much upheaval around them. Still, I feel like you have sort of engaged in this energy a lot, sort of caused this upheaval within them. And I am getting that this has all been divinely orchestrated for you two here as well. This whole upheaval, this whole energy of their life really shifting towards what they have always desired it to be, so that the inner matches the outer here for them. So let's see what else wants to come through for you guys here. So for group number one, what is going on with their person here? Spirit, please, what's going on here? What are their person's current thoughts and feelings? I'm getting overall they have very soft, very tender feelings for you here with transformation. They are thinking very, very highly of you here. With the Three of Wands, we have Lord of Established Strength, strong Aries, and strong Sun energy, which is the Leo energy here. So we have strong sense of confidence that this is sort of right, what's happening right now. I feel like they feel in their bones that this connection is very, very important, that it is sort of very validating for them, but that it's also just the beginning of this connection. It feels like it's growing, it feels like it's developing, you know, it feels like you are only now starting your chapters together. Even though you two might have known each other for quite a while or been in some type of energetic contact here for quite a while, it does seem like right now this is the time when this connection is sort of taking off. There's a lot of confidence, there's a lot of that Aries energy sort of going for it, you know, being there, being the sort of pioneer and working through this, and sort of having faith that it is all working out for the best. So let's see right now what else. I am, however, getting that this person is still suspended. So even though they are in this strong sense of belief that everything is coming to them, that you are right now on the brink of starting something, on the brink of birthing some type of new energy together here with the Three of Wands, I'm still getting that this person is in the midst of a transformation. So this is also why they might be moving a little bit more slower than just this Three of Wands energy here implies. So yes, your person is having faith, but they are still sort of in the upheaval of their life with this transformation here showing up. So let's see what else. Spirit, please, what else? What can you tell us here? We have the Two of Swords. So they are currently in the midst of a decision also. So where do they want to go? They are sort of, Spirit is saying, they are suspended so that they can choose with their free will where they want to go, where they want to go next. What type of life do they want to live next with you? What type of life do they want here? What type of queen do they want, or which queen do they want? With the Queen of Cups, you know, do they want to go for the love of their lives, or will they settle for a frog? I don't even know why that came up here, but it's just like the channeling makes me say weird things sometimes. But yeah, with the Queen of Cups, this person sees you as incredibly beautiful, incredibly nurturing. They are very connected to your feminine energy, regardless of gender, you know, so they really admire and are very fascinated, charmed by the gentleness and also the nurturing energy that you provide, also the energy of surrender. They definitely feel very strongly for that energy within you. It feels like you're an inspiration to them when it comes to spirituality, and also that just the energy of going with the flow, the energy of surrendering to spirit, the energy of letting spirit take the lead and guide you towards where you have to go. With the Queen of Cups, they see you as someone who is also very, very dreamy. So you have sort of like an angelic quality to your own being that is not surprising with the Opalite being here also. So you have that sort of very ethereal quality to you, which this person is very, very guided towards, very drawn towards even. So let's see what else, Spirit. What else can you tell us? We have the Two of Wands. Okay, passions ignite, Lord of Dominion here. We have strong Aries and Sagittarius energy coming through now. So overall, we do have very, very strong fire energy. We do have the Queen of Cups here with the water sign, which is Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio energy. Doesn't have to resonate, but it might resonate for some of you. But here we have the Two of Wands. This to me feels like it's just passion, it's just a strong sense of sexual awakening here. Also, this has strong sensual overtones to itself as well. It feels like this person is very, very drawn to you, very attracted to you, very magnetized by you. They get completely lost whenever they are in your surroundings. I feel like they get completely sort of swooped in by you, by your energy. They are incredibly fascinated by you. This person really does, you know, feel a lot of intensity towards you. And I'm getting with both of these Three of Wands and Two of Wands that they are thinking of making steps or thinking of making progress towards you here. So that's definitely coming through. I feel like with the Two of Swords, they're definitely sort of aiming more towards this Queen of Cups. With the Two of Swords, it does feel, however, like they have to settle something in their current life also. Like something, some type of residue, some type of baggage needs to be sort of cleared out, shuffled out for them to make room for this new connection, which they are aiming for, which they are sort of moving towards regardless of what happens. Let's see what else. It feels like this person is in a strong sense of faith that they are meant to sort of connect with you or be with you here. There's just this strong sense of like surrender and knowledge that you two are meant to be together. With the Devil reversed, I'm getting that there has been a lot of healing in this connection. It might have been that this person is right now moving out of the dark night of the soul, or that they have sort of gotten a grasp of their own addictions. Maybe they had certain sort of sexual tendencies towards you here that they have really mastered at this point as well. I'm getting like there is a complete set of mastery of oneself here with the Devil energy. We have Lord of the Gates of Matter, and it's got just a strong sort of Saturn-like vibe, but also it feels very expansive to me. Like this person has a sense of just a strong sense of masculine energy with control and with sort of having the upper hand upon their own desire, upon their own addictive patterns, upon their own habits, so that they can choose with their free will what they are really wanting. I feel like this person is currently moving out of the dark night of the soul and the sort of the hanged man sort of type of energy with all of this suspension and transformation going on. It's like that energy is leaving their system at this time. Then we have here the Page of Swords or the Princess of Swords. With the Princess of Swords, I am tapping into the energy of this person wanting to meet you. They want to talk to you. They want to communicate. But right now, it feels like they are just sort of thinking about what they want to communicate to you, but not really thinking about making any steps towards you to actually actualize this in the physical, but they are definitely sort of having a lot of inner monologues about what they want to do, what they want to say to you, how they would want to meet you, or how in general they would like to orchestrate your meeting, and what they do want to say to you, what they want to communicate to you, and just basically how they want to, for some of you, even apologize or explain their behavior recently. So what has been going on with them, with their life, they definitely want to come clean and explain that to you. Let's see what else here, Spirit, for group number one here, please. What else can you share with us? We have the Star, so incredible, hopeful energy. We have the Lord of Ruin, also reversed. The Four of Wands here is reversed, however, underneath the Star. So we have a lot of hopeful energy with the Star showing up. This is also strong Aquarius energy. So it feels like this person is coming into their full potential. They are definitely stepping into their authentic self in regards to this connection, in regards to you. I feel like they definitely want to come clean and they want to just explain to you what has been going on with them, what has been happening, and why they have acted like they have acted towards you, causing this confusion. So what they want to do, they want to just settle all the scores and come clean towards you. With the Four of Cups, however, here, I am getting like this person is not immediately ready for like a full-blown connection. They want to just get to know you better, is what I'm feeling into here. They want to explore this connection further. They are realizing there is deep love here with the Queen of Cups. They are realizing there are a lot of tender emotions towards you and a lot of passion that they are feeling towards you, but they are not yet immediately like 100% sure how they want to commit or to what extent they would want to commit to you. So they would want to sort of go on a couple more dates with you just to find out more about you, just to get to know you better so that they know how and why they want to commit to you and what type of commitment they want to build with you here with the Four of Wands. With the Ten of Swords, this is just the energy that the difficulty is currently leaving their life space, their lifespan, the current timeline that they are in. The difficulty is basically leaving, so there is not much to worry about here. Good things are coming to them with this strong sort of source sun energy. You know, the sun is coming up again after this dark night of the soul moment that they have been in, or just if they have been in some type of a difficult moment or difficult sort of circumstances recently, everything is working itself out and joy is again entering the picture here with the Ten of Swords reversed. I do want to talk a little bit more here with the Four of Wands. I am getting like they do want something more strong and solid with you, but I feel like given the circumstances that they have been in with transformations still sort of prevalent in their lives, they want to take it slower. Like, I'm not saying snail slow. They do want to take steps towards you with the Four of Wands, but I'm also getting like they want to have it sort of work out perfectly. Like, they don't want to rush into anything is what I'm sensing here. With hope, I'm getting like there is strong hope in this connection. There is strong sense of being able to be truly authentic with one another here. So yeah, with the world of perfected work here, I am getting that there is just this strong focus on passion at the moment, but this person also wants to figure out what else is there. So is this connection only just passion and feeling very tenderly towards you, or is this, you know, more of a monogamous situation where they would want to commit to you even more strongly? So yes, we have Temperance on the bottom of the deck. So beautiful. So this person is definitely after balance. They are after reconciliation. They want to build with you anew. They want to explain themselves. They really want to just be honest with you, and they want to say they're sorry if they have hurt you in any way. With Temperance, we have strong Sagittarius energy here as well. So this is just strong honest energy. You know, this person wants to come clean. They don't want to be wishy-washy or, you know, lie in any sense. If they have been in that energy before, they want to just come clean and be completely honest with you from now on. Let's see what else wants to come through now with the Erotic Fantasy Tarot. So let's see, Spirit, please, for group number one, what's their person currently feeling here? What's going on here in this connection at the moment, please? So what's going on here? We have the King of Swords showing up so strong, Libra, Aquarius, and also I wanted to say Sagittarius again. I'm not sure why, but Gemini energy here is strong as well. There is a lot of focus, like a huge portion of focus is on communication with you, coming clean, coming straight, being like just totally honest with you, and just communicating what they have been up to, how they have been acting, why they have been acting, how they have acting. Like they want to bring clarity to you, bring clarity to this connection, just that every single score and everything between you is sort of straight and settled here. They are definitely sort of on the road towards that. That's strongly and mainly on their mind here also is what's coming through. So Spirit, please, what else? What else? I'm liking these shadows here. So it's almost like, you know, the sun is shining. The sun is coming through on this group, on this person. The sun is illuminating them and taking away the shadow. And we have now the Four of Wands upright. So interesting. I am now connecting here that this person might even be ready to commit to you once every single thing is a little bit more settled in their lives with this transformation. So as transformation moves out, as the sun comes in, as a beautiful metaphor here, they will be ready to commit to you even more. This person admires you. They really love you. They really appreciate you as a partner, as a spouse, as, you know, whatever you want to be to them. They definitely really appreciate you and want you to be theirs is what's coming through. But they do feel like they have to settle things before they are ready to do that. They have to come correct. They have to sort of make things right. And then after they have made things right in their life, after they have sort of resolved all of these transformational themes, they will be ready to commit to you here, I'm getting. So strong energy, Spirit. What else can you say about group number one's person? What are they thinking, feeling about this person, about their connection, please? What has been going on here? What's been happening? What's here? Yeah, we have the Five of Pentacles. With the Five of Pentacles, the energy is about trusting the divine. It feels like this person is going through a rough patch, which is again sort of clarified with the Five of Pentacles here. This is often about just troubles in the financial business world or just in terms of health. Maybe this person has been dealing with some difficulty in just the physical world, maybe with their family, maybe with their health, maybe with their finances or something relating to that. Maybe something has ended and they just had to sort of take some time off to sort of settle those affairs as well. But they are here with their eyes focused on the divine, focused on the divine feminine energy, and focused on this representation of you, basically, because they do recognize and see you as the divine feminine energy in this connection, regardless of gender here again. So yeah, they see you, they sort of pray to you, they see you as the light at the end of the tunnel even here. So wow, gorgeous energy. They're deciding to not focus so much on the difficulties here anymore with all of these snakes here. They're deciding to focus on the positive, on what they are wanting. So they are realizing the power of their own focus here also. Yeah, and we have the Ten of Swords coming through again, which is again just mirroring that this person is going through quite a difficult time at the moment. They are facing a lot of anxiety, a lot of traumatic events might be coming up, maybe even sort of post-traumatic stress disorder from their childhood or something related to that is coming through for them at the moment, and they're going to quite a really, really difficult time right now. So that's important to know, because, you know, we just have to practice a little bit of gratitude for them here as well, even though, you know, they might not have acted in a good way towards you. It's still important to practice gratitude and understanding towards your fellow people on this planet. So Spirit, what else? What guidance messages do you want to share with us for this group today? Spirit, please, thank you. We have look inside yourself. So Spirit is asking you to examine what is causing you to feel this way. If you have been feeling down, or if you have been feeling out of balance recently, Spirit is asking you to do some introspection, to look within. Spirit also wants to give you some guidance here with these two cards. And the first one is, life is a series of constantly shifting cycles. When we resist change, we resist the natural flow of life and create unnecessary stress. Go with the flow. You will be surprised where it leads. So you're invited to trust, to just go where your gut feeling, where your intuition, where synchronicity, where other people in this life right now are guiding you towards. So it's important to trust in the power of the now, to trust and sort of ground yourself in the here and now, to be there and to allow inspiration to guide you through life. And to top that off, here we have another beautiful message, and it says, you may not always understand why certain things happen, however, there is always a higher purpose to the elements and events in your life. Through turmoil, a blessing will soon be revealed. So this is both a message to you, but also a message that is about this person coming back into your life very, very soon. So through difficulty, a new dawn or new cycle will begin here. Something new will happen. The sun will shine again. And you two will be reconnected. Here I'm getting with these beautiful imagery. We have sacred union. So sacred union, honor and treasure your relationship, for it is truly sacred. Yeah. And we are going to get you some guidance now also. So for group number one, please, Spirit. Guidance for group number one here. Thank you. You got three cards. Like, that's quite a lot. So the first card for you is number 33. We have take responsibility for your life as a creative adventure. How can you live with more meaning, integrity, and truth? So Spirit is asking you to reflect upon these questions, to reflect how you can live with more integrity, with more truth to yourself. Then we have here number 29, deep inward journey. You'll be rewarded for the work. How can you alchemize your fear? So if you have been fearing about something, or if you have been stressing about a certain outcome, it's important that you don't resist that, but that you sort of feel a connectedness towards that fear here, that you try to sort of alchemize it through that connection. So once you release resistance, it will naturally sort of come to you, and it will naturally alchemize into something that is much more easy to handle, much more easy to deal with, and much more easy to just recognize and see where it's coming from, and then also to shift and change into something more positive for you. And then we have number 44, so 3344 might be a sign for you here also. We have come together, we need each other. So this is strongly about connection, practicing connection and connectedness with other people. Where have you been separating yourself or pushing against others and the world? Is your guidance with this card. So where have you been separating yourself from other people? Where have you been pushing against others here and not allowing them to be a part of your life? Let's see now also what the Rose Guidance wants to transmit to you today. So group number one, please, Spirit. Group number one, what can you share with us today? We have the Great Mother showing up with us. So very beautiful energy. With the Great Mother, we have this energy of ancestors coming through for us today. We also have the energy of surrendering into the mystery again and falling into her arms. So falling into the arms of the universe, into the unknown here. So what Rose basically wants to transmission here to you is the following. I am ready to embrace the extremes of my life. I lay all that I'm carrying onto the altar and fall into the Great Mother's arms. So remember that while these extremes are difficult in your life at the moment, they can also be magnificent. That unrestrained joy is closer to grief than we think. And perhaps the more wildly the pendulum of your life swings to and fro, the more you can also say, I have truly lived this life to the fullest and truly express myself to the fullest here. So this is basically your guidance here to surrender even more than you have before. So thank you so much for connecting with me, group number one. I hope this reading resonated. I hope it was beneficial for you and it brought you clarity. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe if you feel like doing that. And if you're interested in booking a tarot reading, all the information about that is in the description box below this video. I hope this was wonderful and beneficial for you. I hope it brought you clarity. Thank you so much for connecting with me and for sharing your energy with me today. And I'm looking forward to connecting with you again in another one of my videos. Bye. Hello, group number two. If you have picked this Yukonite crystal for your reading today, this is going to be the reading for their current thoughts and feelings about you. So first of all, we're going to be getting some oracle cards, then top that off with some tarot, and then also we're going to be getting some guidance for you on your road in this connection. So let's see what wants to come through. Spirit, please, group number two. Wow, very outspoken. Willpower, improve your willpower to reduce your stress level. I almost read that like street level. I feel like with this willpower here, this person is getting ready to step up. This feels like a very action-oriented energy. The energy in general just feels like going there and doing it. It almost feels like not thinking too much or having just a certain amount of thinking that you reach a decision and then sort of going for it. It's just a very strong energy of doing it and that's it. So I feel like this person is going to be stepping up and moving towards you very, very soon if they haven't already. I feel like they have made their decision and they know what they want and they're just going for it, basically. That's what they're doing. So let's see what else Spirit wants to say here for group number two. Okay, so we have quite a few cards. We have live in the moment, trust in your gut showing up, and we have happy life here and beyond the ego. Very interesting. And free will here on the bottom of the deck. So get out of your cocoon. This person is getting ready to step out of their comfort zone and to just step up and come towards you. That is either to express some type of admiration or love towards you, or just the fact that they like you and want to spend more time with you. I feel like, yeah, this is the whole energy here is just about really getting the guts to speak your truth. It feels like the energy is very airy in general. So the Mercury communication is very high in this whole reading. Like the vibe is just about the air signs, the Libra, Gemini and Aquarius. Here is what I'm picking up. And yeah, it's just about communication. It feels like we are interested in a happy life, living a less guarded life. So getting out of that cocoon, getting out of that comfort zone and speaking our truth. Then we have here beyond the ego, getting over ourselves, surrendering to the flow of life. It feels like this person is just really like, I can't wait anymore. I have to have them. I have to be with them. It feels like they are done sort of suffering, feeling bad about themselves. They are done sort of second guessing themselves or being their own blockage on the road. They're just sort of deciding that they are done with all of their shenanigans and they are ready to go for it and to just take a chance here. They are, yeah, trusting themselves. They trust their gut. Let your heart lead you to who you are. So they definitely are beginning to trust more into themselves, into what they are feeling for you, and trusting that all will work out as it has to for both of you, for yourself and for them in this connection. Then we have live in the moment. I feel like with this live in the moment, there's a special energy of them just listening to gurus or, you know, self-help experts. I'm getting like Tony Robbins, and also some other people who are interested in like spiritual guidance, but also just the guidance related to focus and getting your life in order. Like, I don't know, but Tony Robbins is really stepping up to me strongly. But yeah, that's the type of energy here that I'm getting, you know, live in the moment. I feel like this person might also be listening to Osho or Ram Dass or related gurus just to get themselves sort of hyped up into the energy that they want to resonate with. So that they can then lead and come towards you from this very heightened energy from live in the moment here. They are definitely focused a lot on just making the conscious choice to come towards you and making the conscious choice about how they want to live their life. That's very strongly, strongly resonating here. We have also happy life, so they are focused on how they can manifest the best life for themselves, which also involves manifesting the type of relationship that they are wanting. And since we have that sense of liking here, so this person is fond of you. I wouldn't say they love you, but I feel like they are fond of you. So they are thinking about just stepping up towards you. Let's see what else wants to come through here with the Hermetic Tarot. So let's see for group number two, please, Spirit, what else can you tell us? So we have the Nine of Cups showing up, Lord of Material Happiness. So this beautiful card of basically waiting for things to happen. It feels like a little bit of laziness, like this person is just waiting for everything to fall in its place for them to move towards you. I'm getting this strong sense of this person basically meditating and manifesting what it is that they are wanting. It's just that strong energy of working towards what they want with this Nine of Cups energy. It's just focusing strongly on the positive. They might be doing like assumption work or something related to that. It's basically all about manifesting their desires. They are very focused on you. I feel like in general, they are very focused on what they want out of this life. So they are focusing here on material happiness most of all. So how can they manifest something here in the physical that's just going to give them as much happy life here as at all possible? So it's not just on you here, you know, it's not just a romantic relationship. It's also how they can manifest a happy work environment, how they can manifest help for themselves, you know, and for their family, their friends here. So they're definitely in a very manifestation oriented mindset here is what I'm picking up. But what I'm picking up that this is not just about taking action in the physical. This is very strongly for this person currently also about just sitting in their room and sort of meditating. I'm getting like Joe Dispenza energy with this. Yeah. So they might be listening to even Joe Dispenza. I don't know. That's just strongly coming through here. He has certain meditations or those books with You're the Placebo and Becoming Supernatural. I feel like those books do feel like they resonate with this person. Like they have strongly taken that those lessons to heart and they are sort of trying to manifest and work in alignment with that to manifest what they want. So let's see what else for group number two, please, Spirit. What else? What's their person thinking, feeling here? We have the Hanged Man. Yeah, Spirit of the Mighty Waters with the Hanged Man. They are definitely very strongly in spirituality. This is our confirmation here. This feels like just they are trying to look at the world differently. So what this feels like is they are trying to suspend the natural way in which we orient ourselves towards the world. I'm going to get a little bit philosophical with you guys. So in phenomenology, how you usually orient yourself towards the world is basically the natural attitudes. That's the term. That's what we call it. And when you sort of suspend that belief, how you naturally approach objects, things, situations, people, you are entering in the so-called phenomenological attitude. So you are not just embedded in the things habitually as you usually take them, but you are sort of just looking at how you approach those situations as well. So you are focusing on the acts of constitution and manifestation here as well. So sorry for this little philosophical detour, let's call it like that, but I feel like your person here is sort of on that mission. They are doing that without maybe even realizing that they are doing that. I do have to point out that the mystics and also many of these spiritual teachers, they are teaching these concepts that philosophers such as Heidegger, Husserl have been explaining in terms of philosophical works for quite a long time, but they are just sort of reiterating these same truths in a different manner. So sorry about that. I feel like my philosophy student person came through here, but yeah, that's definitely, you know, the energy. They are looking at how they can manifest things. They're not looking at their past anymore. So that habits, how they used to have, what type of energy they used to have, who they used to hang with, they are looking at what they want moving forward. So what type of life do they want to manifest and what type of life they do want to live here and what they want to have in terms of material happiness in their physical life. We have the Queen of Wands, so beautiful, on the bottom of the deck here. I'm feeling like they see you as someone very passionate with the Queen of Wands here, someone very sociable, or at least they definitely admire your skills and how you approach people. This is the energy of like this person liking how you interact with people, how you approach people. There is a sense of beautiful connection that you have with people. Even if you feel like you're a little bit shy at times, this person really admires and likes the way that you hang around others. Yeah, you have a sense of strong passion, strong conviction that this person really, really admires about you also. I feel like they in general see you in a very beautiful high light. I just saw 11:11 on the clock right now, so that might be a confirmation for some of you. But also they see you as someone who's very sort of confident, someone who is like a no bullshit type of person. Not sure if I can say that on YouTube. But yeah, just this passionate individual, they think you are one of the kind. So you definitely stand out to them, almost like, you know, a fire in the forest. You stand out to this person. That's what, just a weird comparison to make, but it was just given to me. So let's see what else. Spirit group number two, please. Too many wanting to come through. So group number three, please. What else can you tell us? What's their person thinking, feeling here? What are they thinking, feeling? We have the Three of Swords. Wow. Lord of Sorrow. I think like they are trying to maybe move through the difficulties in their past here. We have this Three of Swords for a reason here. This might be just me having to tell you that this person is also dealing with something very, very difficult at the current time, which has for some of you nothing to do with you. For others, it might be something related to your connection. Maybe something went wrong in this connection. This person is trying to fix this. Maybe there was a conflict in your situation, given that there is a Five of Swords here on the bottom of the deck as well. That's just for some of you. For others of you who don't resonate with this, the energy feels like this person is dealing with some type of past hurt or some type of heartbreak. This heartbreak does not mean that they have lost a romantic partner. This can just mean that something in regards to family or around their friendship zone or friend zone is causing them sorrow here. This person has not been coming towards you because they are still dealing with this sorrow, because they feel like they have been really deeply cut. And they are just trying to heal themselves at the moment because they feel like they can't come towards you with this love that you deserve. This is like a confirmation, like for you to know why this person has not been coming through towards you. It's because of this Three of Swords, because they have been healing, feeling heartbroken. They have been healing that, okay? So it's going to resonate differently, the circumstances for this energy, but this is here just to for you to know what has been going on with them. All right, Spirit, what else? What else do you have for us here? Okay, we have the, we have the Ace of Pentacles, the Knight of Pentacles. We have the Hermit on the bottom of the deck now. So yeah, this person is definitely taking their time off to look within, to search for answers here in terms of spirituality, especially with the Hermit. I'm tapping strongly into the energy of hermits in India, where they, you know, people actually go live in the cave and people bring them food to those caves. But these people are like completely sort of separate from society. Well, not 100%, but they are there to just focus on their consciousness and focus on, for example, shamanic parts of that type of techniques, or at least they try to focus on strong lucid dreaming. Tibetan shamanism is very strong in that area as well. Just, you know, something that I want to share here. But yeah, this person is focusing on those types of things. They are trying to heighten their consciousness, and I feel like they're definitely focusing on different ways of expanding their consciousness through meditation. Here is what's coming through. But they are also interested in making you an offer with the Ace of Pentacles. Like with the Knight of Pentacles, with the Ace of Pentacles, this person is definitely interested in building something further with you. They want to offer you something. They want to give you something. They are kind of sorry that they have been taking a long time to realize this, or a long time to get back to you, even if you are in a correspondence of some kind. But they are interested in building something with this Ace of Pentacles. They want something like physical with you here in this lifetime. Let's see what else he wants to come through with the erotic fantasy now. Erotic fantasy, please, for group number two, please, Spirit. What else? What have I missed? Yeah, we have the Five of Cups. They're walking away from a difficult situation in their life. Again, this is going to resonate differently for all of you. For some of you, it's your own situation. For others of you, it's just a difficult circumstance that they are leaving behind here with this Five of Cups energy. They're leaving something very, very difficult behind, and this has been causing them a lot of heartbreak here, and they are gaining strength to just to go through this situation here. This is maybe also why they have been searching for this spiritual side of reality, why they have been dabbling into these energies lately, because they needed something to comfort them, you know. So maybe that's why they have been watching or connecting with spiritual gurus recently, to just give them hope and to know how they can shift this and move towards a better tomorrow very quickly. With the strength here, we have just strong energy of emotional resilience, emotional truth coming to the surface. I feel like this person is being very honest or is intending to be very, very honest with you moving forward. Another thing coming through here is that they are focusing on their emotional intelligence. So if they have hurt you in the past, they are trying to work through that so that they don't hurt you again. This person has good intentions in their own heart, so they are really trying to come through correctly for you, and they are trying to work on their manifestations here, but also work on their connection with source, with spirit, with the high priestess. This is just like a confirmation of that hanged man here and the hermit here. So yeah, they are just, I feel like, also reading some sacred texts, for example, mystics. They're just trying to understand reality better is what's coming through here with this card. They're trying to understand what has happened to them, why that manifested for them, if it was something like very, very difficult in regards to their family or friend circle, or maybe even this connection between the two of you, or, you know, they are trying to just see how they can shift their reality and what can be done about that reality. So overall, they feel like they are learning about things, and the end goal of all of this is basically to have a beautiful, happy life, and to also be with you, to have a beautiful, happy life with you, and to come towards you. We have the Chariot on the bottom of the deck here, and we have a couple here making love. So I feel like this is just a very beautiful energy, like a confirmation for you that yes, this person wants to come forward. They want to have a family with you. They want to have a life with you. This is strong Cancer energy, which is all about home, just protection, and having that sense of comfort in a home life. I'm also feeling like this person is integrating their shadow and light here with these Sphinx characters. I want to give you these cards. Let's see what comes through for group number two. What are their current thoughts and feelings about them, about this connection? What else wants to come through here? Yeah, I'm getting the energy of grieving, just a little bit of sadness there. But we have travel. Yeah, this person wants to come towards you. They want to travel towards you here. They're thinking about you non-stop, spirit wants to say. So before they fall asleep, especially, they are thinking about you. They are trying to bring your energy into their sleep world. I feel like maybe they're even connecting with you through your dreams here, with the High Priestess being here. Maybe in the astral realms, you two are very, very connected as well. Let's see what else, spirit. Yeah, we have home. So the energy of home is very strong here. You two feel like home. Your person feels like you are their home. You might feel like that's the same way you feel as well here, but definitely they feel very comfortable with you. They feel like they can be themselves around you. They really appreciate you. And we have strength again showing up. They're trying to build up strength to come towards you and to deal with the difficulty in their personal life that they are currently dealing with here. Let's see what else. We have psychic abilities. I feel like this might even be that they are developing their own psychic abilities or developing their intuition here, with also trust your gut feeling here. So they might be developing their intuition, their third eye, their connectedness to spirit. But this one also does feel like you two are connecting on a more telepathical level. So you might be having dreams about this person, or this card is just to tell you that this person has been having dreams about you, that they have been connecting with you through the astral realm. But yeah, I'm getting for most of you, there's also a telepathical connection, because I have been getting this energy of communication here very strongly. And I'm getting, like, with this eye, this third eye, I'm getting just a strong energy of telepathic communication. So you two might be, you know, sort of talking to each other astrally, or connecting to each other's higher selves in the astral dimension, sort of channeling their voice or hearing their voices in your own head here also. So it's not just happening in your head. Spirit also wants to say, if you have been feeling like you're a little bit lost or a little bit out of it, you know, it's nothing out of the ordinary. It's just that you two are very, very connected on the astral level, which is then sort of being channeled through you into your physical manifestation as well, because you are an open channel for that at this time. I also saw 2222 when I was telling you about this message. So if that resonates for any of you, or if that is a sign for any of you, I just wanted to mention it. I'm being guided to get you one last card here. Yes, this one, we have finding, such a beautiful energy. This is such a warm, heartfelt energy, like the heart chakra basically resonating out. This is how this person feels towards you, like a warm hug, like you around them. You feel comforting, you feel like a warm hug, like a warm embrace, and they just love to have you in their lives. Okay, now we're going to give you some guidance. We're going to be using the Lover's Oracle for this one. So let's see. Okay, Spirit already wants to talk. So time, you are trying too hard, give it time. Somewhat, sometimes difficult to hear or to listen to this, but Spirit is asking you to give it time, to trust, to close your eyes and tell yourself that you deserve to feel joyful. You can allow joy into your life regardless of the circumstances you currently find yourself in. So if you have been struggling with feeling joy recently, remember, you can always choose to feel joy. It's about choice. It's about that free will for you to just let that energy into your life. Do not resist that energy from coming into your life here. And let's see what else, Spirit, for group number two, please. What can you share with us in regards to their person, regards to this energy? We have healing coming through, and we also have trust. So healing, such a beautiful card. This one says, imagine yourself and your beloved surrounded by light. Feel your relationship being healed this very moment. If you needed a message about what to do or a guidance about what to do, this is your guidance here. And also we have trust here to reconnect and trust each other through your heart. Transformation occurs through acceptance. Once you accept the current situation, it will automatically transform. So that resistance, again, you know, as with time, I was feeling into this resistance from you as we got this time. You know, you're being told that you're trying too hard and that you have to sort of let it go and surrender. And the similar message is here with trust. You sort of have to let go, and it's about that resistance that you are currently holding. It's like, if I let go, I will lose it, or I will not have it. But that's not the case at all. It's just about transforming and letting Spirit take the lead, letting Spirit take you and give you the occurrences, the circumstances, the relationships that you are needing, and the way that you need them to come to you. Spirit knows best. So you have to do is trust that everything is coming to you. You also are being told to honor each other, to honor this union between the two of you that you have. We have sexual union on the bottom of the deck here, which says honor the place in one another where you are one eternal soul, for there you will find true bliss, but there is also true bliss. All right, so that's the psychic abilities energy that I was telling you about. You two are connected on the astral level very, very strongly, I'm getting, and it's just about honoring each other and honoring each other's expression. But also Spirit is inviting you to give each other some space at the moment, to trust and have faith that all will work out for the best here. Alrighty, so let's give you some guidance for group number two, please, Spirit. Group number two guidance here, please. Okay, we have number 17. Trust your faith. Dive into the unfolding journey. Your question or soul inquiry is, what is your faith asking of you? Okay, so there is the message, and here is beautiful card. We also have this one wanting to come through here. This one is number 36, the leader of the light. Where are you being called to serve and support others? So there's your guidance. Where can you support others? How can you step up and support others? Maybe even how can you step up and support this person here if you're being called to support them in any way? Okay, what else? Well, many cards wanting to come through here. We have the Rose Garden, innocence, forgiveness, and being gentle with yourself. Okay, let's get you one more. One already did flip through here. Let me just find it. We have release the petals. So it's about transformation. It's about death and rebirth, shedding and all change. Okay, so let's first of all look at the Rose Garden here. So let's see the Rose Garden. This one is, wow, so sorry, drop the card. This one is about innocence, forgiveness, being gentle with yourself. Spirit is reminding you that you are holy and whole. You are innocent and innately good, and you are wholly welcome here wherever you are. And what you can ask yourself here is basically, how can you be more gentle with yourself? You do have to remember that we are all doing the best we can. When we learn, we can choose to do something new. So Spirit is inviting you here today to commit to learning and doing better each and every day. This is what it means to be human. To embrace our humanness is what you are being called to do. And without it, basically we deny the shadow also. And it's through facing the shadow without defense and without that sense of resistance that we can learn and grow. So you are being invited here to embrace your humanity, and you'll find it easier to embrace other people and the whole world as well here. And then we have here the other card, which is about releasing the petals. And releasing the petals is basically about transforming. It's transformation, death and rebirth, shedding all change. Strong Scorpio energy here for those of you who maybe resonate with that. So this card is basically calling you towards the inquiry that is asking you, what are you clinging to for fear of nothing coming to take its place? Okay, so if you're clinging on to this relationship, why are you clinging on to this? What are you being afraid will happen? So this card is a change basically, yes. This is a card of change and transformation. So Spirit wants you to know that courage is required for the rebirth to happen. And we can grasp the petals of the past as the changing winds blow, but eventually we all discover that change is coming, change is near, and change is already here for us. And while what once was is no longer, and what soon will be is not yet happening, it's still time to release your petals and take that chance to begin again. Spirit is telling you that it is now time to surrender so the transformation can happen for your life here also. Had the rose not released its petals, the rose hip would not have come to be. So remember that. When we gather the courage to release what was, we are greeted by the fruits of the future. So focus on that. What are you clinging to for fear of nothing coming to take its place? And be brave enough to release those petals to the winds and trust that this beautiful change is coming into your life and that you're always guided towards what is best for you. So thank you so much for connecting with me, group number two. It's been an honor and a privilege to read for you today. Thank you for sharing your energy. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. If you're interested in booking a personal tarot reading with me, all the information can be found in the description box below this video and also in the pinned comment below. I'm sending you so much love, so much light, and looking forward to connecting with you soon again through another one of my videos. Have a beautiful day, my group number two. Bye. Mwah. Hello, group number three. So if you pick this rose quartz today for your reading, this is going to be the tarot reading for their current thoughts and feelings about you. So we're going to be getting some oracle cards just to get into the energy of your person to see where they currently are, and then we're going to be getting some tarot and also some oracle cards and guidance for you guys. So let's see for group number three here, Spirit, please. What's going on here? What's going on with their person for group number three? Their current thoughts and feelings. So group number three, person's thoughts and feelings here, please, Spirit. What's happening? What's happening here? Okay, we have make a change. Welcome change into your life. So sorry, there are some noises from the outside. I'm not sure if you heard that. Yeah, make a change. This person is thinking about shifting things up. It does feel like what they are currently working on, what they're currently going through, is not really making them happy. I feel like some of you, you might have had a little bit of a falling out because this person was focused on just doing things as they always did them, and they were very sort of, let's say, stuck, or they wanted to just stay in their comfort zone. It's not like they were stuck. They made a choice with their free will here to stay in their comfort zone. But right now, it feels like this person is wanting to get out of their cocoon here with the free will card. They are wanting to come towards life with new perspectives. They're wanting new adventures, and they want new adventures for your relationship here as well. It feels like they are quite determined to take a step towards you here also, and to just make a change here with you towards an energy of love. Let's see what else. I feel like I'm guided to get like one more card. What are they making a change towards, or what else can you tell us about this person here, Spirit? Thank you. We have silencing the mind wanting to come through here. So, well, what else? Fine wine. Longing is the portal to wholeness. Okay, silencing the mind. Let silence guide you to your inner peace. And we have fine wine here. Longing is the portal to wholeness. I feel like they are trying to silence their inner chatter, their little inner monkey speech, this internal monologue that sort of always going on and on and on. I feel like their internal monologue or their past self is something that's very nestled in, like, in their subconscious, and they are trying to get a new groove going. I don't know why, I'm just feeling into Isra, and I feel like it's Kronk from the Emperor's New Groove type of energy. You know, it's about getting yourself sort of hyped up to take new bold steps towards your life, and to just silence that little inner critic or that little inner analyst that is telling you that this is not a good choice, or that this is not a good way to do this. Like, this person is all about making new changes in their life, and I feel like that definitely involves you here. They want to make a step towards you. It's what I'm getting strongly with this energy. They might have some, let's say, blockages there with this fine wine. It might sometimes feel like it's not a good idea, or they might be feeling like, you know, you might not want them, or there is something separating you two. There does feel like there is something that's causing them to not come towards you as quickly. Like, they are taking their time just to feel out the situation a little better, to get to know you better here with fine wine. It feels like they're maybe thinking a lot over this. They feel like they don't want to make a wrong step, but it also does feel like they are overthinking your situation here a little bit, yet they are still wanting to make a change, wanting to make a step forward. They want to make forward movement. Does feel like the energy is sort of very stifling for them currently in this relationship, so they want to switch it up. They want to do something new. They feel like where they are currently is just very, very boring, and they need something, some type of change to happen. I also saw 444 on the clock. I don't know how we managed to get that high on this number. I thought it was like 2 minutes in, but yeah, that is like a message or some type of a sign for any of you. There it is. Number four is also the sign of the Emperor, which is the sign of the divine masculine awakening. So that's something, and oh my God, we have the Emperor here on the bottom of the deck also. So the divine masculine is indeed awakening for this person. This is strong, strong Aries energy, yes. So it's about making that first step. This is the first house, that fiery movement forward, sort of going for it, you know. Jumping in, going for it, strong masculine energy. It's about control and taking ownership of your life, taking ownership of the life that you are creating. So yes, this person is definitely taking a chance towards you. And we have the Ace of Cups on the bottom of the deck. Such beautiful energy here, you know, with the Emperor, with the Ace of Cups. This is about love being, and love basically awakening. I wanted to say love being awoken, but it's not like that has not happened already. It feels like it's just love awakening more and more and building up more and more for you and this person, becoming more and more aware of that. So let's see what else is coming through here. So they are more and more aware of your love, also conceptually aware of how they feel towards you. It might have been that before they were sort of brushing this energy off or were not so accustomed to feeling this way, but now they are starting to realize just how much you mean to them. And as I'm saying that, I'm just feeling this beautiful swell of energy, sort of my heart almost feels like the Grinch's heart sort of swelling to a lot. I don't know, my words are failing me. I feel like this person might feel like that because I'm completely losing my ability to speak and to form like coherent sentences. It's causing me like a lot of just effort to speak in a normal manner. So I'm getting like this person might get quite flustered about you, or you just make them very nervous. It's like they forget to speak around you, or how to speak and what to say, because they get so overwhelmed with their own feelings for you, which is just very, very beautiful. You know, you completely override their frontal cortex here and just focus on the amygdala and emotional connections, which is very beautiful in a sense. You know, it just is that this person might take that to be hard for them because they do thrive on being able to communicate with the Emperor. You know, they want to have that skill or that ability to communicate better with you, but they just sort of shut down whenever they are around you, which is just so cute for them. But yeah, let's see what else. Definitely there's a lot of love here, you guys, so don't forget that. With the Ace of Cups, we have love awakening and love sort of being filled up more and more for you and your connection. So let's see what else. We have the Last Judgment reversed. With the Last Judgment reversed, just feels like this is a very plain, beautiful road. It doesn't feel like there are too many sidetracks or things to be done in this connection anymore. It's just about making a choice, like making a strong, willful choice, strong intention towards wanting this and then going towards this connection. With the Last Judgment, I'm getting like no one is standing in the way of this connection except you two. It feels like you are the only ones who are maybe overthinking this or not focusing on this connection in the right way, which is making it move at a sluggish pace. But Spirit is saying that if you wanted this today, you could have it today. So you are the only one sort of standing in your way. This person is the only one standing in their own way here towards having you and to having this beautiful connection with you. And we have the Two of Cups here on the bottom of the deck. Just how beautiful is that? You know, we have the two whales here swimming together. And whales are the type of animals, you know, that form really long-lasting bonds. They feel like very monogamous creatures to me personally. And they are just the type of creature that lives in water, which is that emotional energy and that energy of source and creation. And just that there's such a beautiful energy of just coexisting together in harmony, which is what this person is wanting. We have the Lord of Love for you guys, just very gorgeous energy overall. We have the Ten of Cups now on the bottom of the deck, you guys. So crazy. I can't even, if I try to make this up, I couldn't. Then we have the Three of Wands, which is all about excitement, you know, that next road forward, that new creative energy, that new creative endeavor that you can take on together. This is about action. Action in terms of what else is coming our way. So this person feels very excited about what is going to come towards you and what is going to develop in this connection next. How is this connection going to develop further? They feel very, very excited about that. This is strong Aries energy as well as Leo energy coming through here. So I do feel like they're quite confident about you, and they are again in that strong Aries energy, which is the energy of beginnings. And how I'm basically feeling the Aries energy here is just, you know, moving through, moving towards what it is that you are wanting, like full speed ahead. But it's just, it feels like this person is what standing in their own way here with less judgment. That's all there is. Like they're overthinking, or maybe their feelings of something not being valuable or something not being right is what's holding them back here. It's just themselves. There's nothing else here that would be talking about any type of hurdle or anything difficult in this connection. We even have the Devil reversed. So I feel like overall we have many green lights here. And as I was looking through the... This happened. So as I was looking through the whole thing, sort of just going through like that, the Three of Pentacles and the Lovers is showing up for us here. So Gemini energy, but also that energy of love and sacred union is showing up for us here. But also with the Three of Pentacles, this person wants to have something with you in the physical reality. They want to build towards something with you. They want to build towards a life with you here. And yeah, we have the Five of Wands reversed. So they don't want any type of conflict anymore. They don't want any type of difficulty anymore or any type of struggle in this connection. Struggle meaning very broadly, you know, they don't want to struggle in this connection to make it happen anymore, or struggle in any way to just bring you two together. They want this to happen effortlessly and in a beautiful manner. And also we have the Queen of Cups here on the bottom of the deck. So you guys, this is really, really insane how beautiful this energy is. With the Queen of Cups, this person sees you as their divine feminine. With the Emperor here, regardless of gender, they see you as a beautiful, nurturing soul who they want to spend time with, who they want to make a home with. This is also strong Cancer energy. There's also Pisces and Scorpio in here, if any of you resonate with that. But overall, this is just the beautiful energy of emotional connection that this person feels with you. They want to build a home with you. And yeah, they want to just fly on the wings of love. Wings of Love, isn't that like a song? I feel like there's a song by Scorpions or someone like that. I'm not sure, but there's the Wings of Something song that might resonate with some of you. If you know that song, please comment below. I can't remember the right name of the song right now, but it's definitely Wings of Something. It's quite popular. I feel like it's old rock, the genre. So yeah, we also have Justice. So Libra energy, that's the energy of love again. This is the strong yin-yang connection. So again, that connectedness between the masculine and feminine polarity, the connectedness between the divine masculine, divine feminine in this connection. So you two might be twin flames or sacred soulmates. But overall, what I'm getting here is that scales are tipping so that it is becoming more easier for you to connect. Scales are tipping in the higher sphere of things, so that things are sort of equal between the two of you. This person wants there to be an equal give and take between the two of you in your connection here as well. So they are really trying hard to just make steps towards you and say things towards you that are going to make it all very harmonious and balanced between both of you. So there are no resentments or no hard feelings, but there's only love here, which is seconded here with the Five of Wands being reversed for you guys. So beautiful. This is such a beautiful energy. All right, so let's get you like one or two of these erotic fantasy tarot cards, because I did that for all the other groups. I feel like I should do that for you as well. So let's see for group number three here, Spirit, what wants to come through here? What do you want to show us? We have the Seven of Wands and we have the Nine of Pentacles. We have the Seven of Pentacles here underneath, the Seven of Wands reverse as well. So what this person is wanting with the Seven of Wands reverse is to not have any walls up for you and in your connection anymore. You know, the Seven of Wands is often about just building walls. For me personally, it's about sort of with tapping with the stick, you know, sort of hitting other people away from you and having this little wall in front of you. But this being reversed, it feels to me like this person is ready to let their guard down for you and to form really genuine, beautiful connections with you. And then with the Seven of Pentacles, they are willing to grow this connection further, to work hard for it, and to really build it from scratch. And with the Nine of Pentacles, they are saying that they see a very beautiful, energetic connection that you two can have, and that they can see a future with you, that they can see themselves building something with you. We have the Nine of Wands, Eight of Wands here as well, Sagittarius energy. They want to definitely come towards you. This is a strong element of taking steps towards someone, taking action towards someone, and they definitely want to also share with you that they want something more proper with you in the physical, but they also see like a long-lasting life with you here with the Nine of Pentacles. So it's not like they just want to be with you for like year, for example. Like this feels like this person wants to move in with you and live with you for like the majority of their life, at least here with the Nine of Pentacles. They feel very empowered by you and they feel like they can share a beautiful, abundant life with you here. Just put this one here as well. So the Eight of Wands is definitely about taking that action towards you. This is a very passionate energy, but it also is saying that this person is very, very focused on you. So there feels like this is like a narrow vision that they have towards you. Like their arrow is set on you. Yes. Gorgeous. I feel like this person really grew, really developed in this connection. I'm getting like they weren't like that before is what I'm feeling here. It's like they had a major transformation here that they are now willing to take their guard down and really take this change in their life and to make a change for you and for this connection to blossom. We have this beautiful Page of Cups here. So it's about them having more vulnerability, being more open to communicate and to be more open in their own emotional space and with their own emotions, both to themselves and towards you here also. But we also have the Empress showing up. So we have the Emperor here, we have the Empress energy here, so beautiful. We have the Divine Couple, even though it's coming from different decks, we have the Divine Couple here. So again, another mirror that this is a sacred connection, this is a sacred union for you two. Let's see what else wants to come through. We're going to be getting some of these little lovers oracle cards as well. So let's see for group number three, please, Spirit. What can you tell us in terms of guidance, but also in terms of this person and their connection? Just too many flipped through here. Okay, we're going to be taking this one. Let's just take one more, please. One more card, please, Spirit. Okay, thank you. Okay, wow, beautiful. A message for you. I'm thinking of you this very moment. Your love fills me with life. I love you. I feel like this is just a message from this person, from your person. So you are being bombarded with this beautiful, loving message here. I feel like some of you are skeptical. Please don't be skeptical of this. This is just divine synchronization here. We also have this beautiful message for you. You may not always understand why certain things happen. However, there is always a higher purpose to the events in your life. So through turmoil or through difficulty, a blessing will soon be revealed to you. This is one of those beautiful blessings. Please don't be skeptical of this. I feel like some of you are. We have transformation. Your relationship with one another is about to deepen. Love conquers and transforms all things. Yes, we are making a strong change. There's a burning heart for you. This person does really burn for you. They feel passionately towards you. And we have my beloved. Though we may be physically apart, spiritually, we are always united. For love transcends space and time. Nothing is missing. Okay? This person wants you to know that they are always feeling a connection with you. You are always connected to them. It's important to remember that what you feel towards them is also maybe sometimes mirrored in them. So it's important to recognize your own feelings for them and also have that type of awareness of how that might be then mirrored for them. I feel like you are a strong divine union and you might be mirroring each other very, very strongly in the physical in terms of emotions, okay? So how you might be feeling about your person is also an indicator of how they might be feeling towards you. So that's how you can maybe sometimes learn to navigate your own relationship here. Yes. So just trust. Spirit is saying all you have to do is trust. And everything is going to come to you. What else? Group number three. You have number six as your guidance. There is strength in doing nothing and to wait. What have you been forcing and how can you let go of the outcome? Spirit is asking you with this hippie card coming through here. So how can you let go of the outcome? Spirit is also saying you can radically change your results by just shifting your beliefs and shifting this resolution that you have about your own outcomes in regards to this. So you can let go of what is really limiting you or how you are limiting yourself in this situation. All right, so now let's get you some rose guidance. So Spirit, please, for group number three, what guidance do you have for them at this time? What guidance do you have here for our beautiful group number three? Collective, please, thank you. We have the return. Wow, wow, okay. So beautiful. So this is about a new story. You decide. And also, it is about alignment. It is all coming together here. So basically, what Spirit wants to talk about with this card is a rose transmission, which is the following. I acknowledge how far I've come and how much I've grown. I decide what happens next. So that's your transmission. That is something that you can remember about this situation, about this person. So you have to acknowledge how far you've come and how much you've grown. But also it's important for you to remember and to know that you always decide what happens next. Spirit is telling you with this card here that things are aligning for you and things are aligning around you. They are convening and coming together so that you are in the right place at the right time. It's important to remember that at all times. Your outer world is basically matching your inner world also. So this card is delivering a message of harmony to you, of coming together. and the embodiment of holding a clear vision about what you are wanting for many years. Spirit wants to say that you have been doing the groundwork to get to this moment right now. Maybe you have been doing that groundwork for like years or even lifetimes. But right now, it's important to use this moment, to trust this moment. And it's important to just remember that you get to decide what happens next. You are the grand mastermind, the grand manifestator. You are the God of your own reality. And it's important for you to just take back that power at this moment with this card. So this is the great return of you as your own manifester, and to reclaim that knowledge, reclaim that truth, reclaim that power for yourself. That's all I have for you, my beautiful group number three. Thank you so much for connecting with me. This has been a beautiful reading to end this whole energetic connection on. Thank you so much for connecting with me. I'm sending you so much love, so much light. Thank you so much to all of our ancestors and to our spirit guides, higher selves, for allowing us to channel these messages today. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already, my beautiful group number three. If you want a personal tarot reading with me, all the information can be found in the description box down below. Other than that, I'm just sending you so much love, so much light, hoping to connect with you soon in another one of my tarot readings, and hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!